morning friends. In previous video, we have seen the classification of the phenols. Now, come toward that, the next point of the phenol, and it is the nomenclature of that is the phenols. Nomenclature of phenols. Nomenclature of phenols. Now, as we know that phenols are classified into three types, and in that the first is the monohydric phenol, second is the dihydric phenol, and third is the trihydric phenol. So let us start the nomenclature of these three phenols. Now therefore, first of all, I will write that the monohydric phenols. Now directly I will write here that some examples of that is the monohydric phenols here. Now the first structure of the monohydric phenol is very simple one, and actually it is the basic structure of that is the phenol, and the structure is like this here. On the benzenic here that the OH group is present here. Okay, so this should be the phenol here. But along with this structure here, now I will write here that some structure here, and then we will see here that which are the names of these structures here. So this will be the second structure. Then after that, the next structures are like this here, OH on the benzene ring here, and the CH3 group is here. Then the next structure is like this here, OH CH3. Then OH NO2. Then OH, and on the aromatic ring is on the benzene ring here, the NO2 is group present here. Then next structure is like this here, OH, then NO2, and one more structure I am writing here, and this is OH and Br. Now here I have written like lots of structures here, and all these are the examples of the monohydric phenol. Now in previous video we have seen that why these structures are known as the monohydric phenols, because as we observe all these structures here that this structure contains here only one type of OH group on the benzene ring here. Okay, that's why these are the monohydric phenols. And in yesterday's period we have seen that the mono, it's a meaning that the single or the one, means here which group is present for one time here, monohydric, and hydric one is for the OH group here. Okay, so here only one OH group is present on the benzene ring. Therefore, all these are the monohydric phenol. And why these are the phenols? Because that the OH group is directly attached to the benzene ring. Therefore, all these are the monohydric phenols. Now, here today's our point is that the nomenclature. That in the nomenclature there are the two naming systems. One is the common name system, and another is that the IUPAC system. Just I will write here that the headlines of these naming systems: common name system and the IUPAC system. Now, one more point that you know very well from the 11th standard, and is that in the aliphatic that the compounds that and in their common name system, the prefixes like N, iso, U, secondary, like that, these are used before the name of the alkyl group. Okay, but here the phenol is not an aliphatic compound. Phenol is an aromatic compound, and in yesterday that the term that I have told you also that phenols are the hydroxy that the compounds. Okay, now here as these are the aromatic compounds. Then in the aromatic compounds or in their common name system, that three prefixes are used, and these prefixes are different from the N iso nu. And which are the three prefixes? Now here, I will write here. In that, one is the ortho. One is the ortho. Or this ortho is used for the here O as a letter. Then next is the ortho. After that, the next will be the meta. Meta represented by the M. And last one is the para. And para, these prefixes are represented by the P letter. Okay. So these three letters are used in the common name system. Now here, first I will write here that the common names of all these structures here, and then I will tell you that why these names came here. Okay. Now actually this structure is known as the ortho cresol. Ortho cresol. Then it is the meta cresol. Whereas it is the para cresol. Para cresol. Then after that, the next structure is known as the ortho nitrophenol. Ortho nitrophenol. Then after, the next is the meta nitrophenol. Then after, the next thing that is the para nitrophenol. Para nitrophenol. And the last picture, its name is that is the ortho bromophenol. So in these all structures that I have used, that ortho, meta and the para prefixes. But one more that the point I would like to take here about that these three structures here, and this is a very important sentence in the nomenclature of the phenol also, that phenols have the names that are different from the common and as well as that in the IUPAC, and from these names that the phenols are famous here. Now actually if we observe here that this structure, then it clearly indicates that on the benzene here that the OH2 IUCH3 group is present here. There means here that here this should be the methyl group here, and actually our parent compound is the benzene and the OH, means it is the phenol here. Therefore it's a another name is that is the ortho methyl phenol. Okay. Now here, according to our this that the prefixes, actually its a name is like this, ortho methyl phenol. But along with here that this name, I have written that the ortho cresol. Means here that phenol have the names actually that are different from the common as well as that the IUPAC. And from these names here that the phenol is that in the famous here. Now actually the cresol name came here due to the here that the substitution of that the OH and the CH3 groups on the here that the benzene name. Okay, therefore it is the ortho cresol, it is the meta cresol and the para cresol. But according to that which substituents are present on the benzene name, therefore it's a common name that is the ortho methyl phenol. Just already I have told you that the benzene and the OH is our that the main compound, means it is the phenol, and on the benzene ring again here that the CH3 group is present here, and this should be the here ortho methyl phenol here. Now here the question arises in our mind is like this here, that why it is known as the ortho methyl phenol? Then its answer is that here, or in the aromatic compounds, that when the two substituents are present in the adjacent position on the benzene ring. Okay, once again I would like to repeat this point here, because this point is very important about that the ortho prefix here. When the two substituents are present on the benzene ring in the adjacent position, then the prefix is the ortho prefix here, and therefore its a common name is the ortho methyl phenol.
Understood? Now, after that, we come to that the next one structure. Now, first of all, I will write here that it's a common name, and then I will take here. Now, it is known as the meta methyl phenol. Now, then, why it is known as the meta? Then, its answer is that when the two substituents of the benzene are in alternate position, means one after the other, means here that here on the benzene here the OH group is present here, and here after this position this should be the next position here, and on this position there is a no any substituent, and after this that the next on the next position here that the CH3 methyl group is present. Means when the two substituents are present on the benzene ring in the alternate position, means one after the other, then the prefix is used, that is the meta prefix. Okay, and therefore it is known as the meta methyl phenol. And then next structure is that the it's a common name is that the para methyl phenol. Now, why do you know the para? Because when the two substituents are present in the opposite position, then that time the prefix is used, that should be the para. Okay, therefore it is known as the para methyl phenol. Okay, so once again I would like to repeat here that about the ortho methyl and the para, means in which conditions ortho prefix is used, or in which condition meta prefix is used, and in which condition that the para prefix is used. About that I am going to tell here or repeat once again here. When the two substituents are present on the aromatic ring in the adjacent position, then the ortho prefix is used. Understood? Then about that the meta, when the two substituents are present one after the other, then the substitution, then the prefix is that in the meta substitution. And when the two substituents are present in the opposite position, then the prefix is the para prefix. Okay, so in this way that the any aromatic compound that these ortho, meta and the para prefixes are used before the name of that is the alkyl group. But I would like to tell one more point about that these prefixes here, that when the substituents are present on the aromatic ring, at least that the two, or means, or in another way, minimum two or maximum two, then and then in that condition these prefixes are used. Suppose here that this should be the first structure here. Now on this structure here, that means on the benzene here, there is only one substitution OH group here. So in this case here, that there should be no meta, no para or no ortho prefix. Means when the benzene contains at least two that the substituents, then and then these ortho, meta and the para prefixes are used. So all these structures contain that the here that the two substituents, therefore here in all these structures that the ortho, meta and the para prefix, there should be a para prefix. Okay, so after this that the next one structure is the orthomatrophenol here. Actually it's a common name is this one. Okay, it is not famous from the other names here. Now here again that the two substituents are present on the benzene ring in the adjacent position, therefore it's a prefix is that in the ortho prefix here. Okay, and on the ortho position here that NO2 nitro group is present here, and our parent compound is the benzene and the OH, therefore its name is the ortho nitro phenol. Okay, then obviously that the in the next structure that the two substituents are present in the one after the other position, there means here that the, on the meta position here that the NO2 group is present here. Okay, therefore its common name is the meta nitro phenol. Okay, whereas in the next structure that the two substituents, which substituents in the OH group and the NO2 group are present in the opposite position, and here that our parent compound is the benzene and the OH means it should be the phenol here. Means in respect with the, this OH group here, the NO2 group is present at the para position. Therefore, it is known as the para nitrophenol. Okay. Whereas the last structure is that is the ortho bromo phenol, because the two substituents are present here in the adjacent position. Okay. So in this way, you can take that lots of examples of that the monohydric phenols or their common names as well as that is the IUPAC names. Now we will discuss here. Okay. So after this, that will come to that IUPAC name. Now, actually, our parent compound in the phenol. Now, the in phenol there should be the here phenol as a common as well as the IUPAC name. Now we have concluded that the structures that is the IUPAC name here. Then, okay. Now you know that in the IUPAC IUPAC nomenclature that the numbers are given. Okay, actually this rule is about that the aliphatic compound as well as that in the aromatic compound. In aliphatic compound, what we do that the number of carbon atoms, that longest chain or straight chain we can select here. Okay, and after that, after selecting that, we are going to give that the numbers to that carbon atoms that are present in the longest chain. Okay, like that here, you have to give the numbers to the aromatic that the here ring, which actually in this aromatic ring, the carbon atoms are present here. You know that the molecular formula of that is the benzene in the C6H6, means in the benzene ring, that here on every that this position here, that the carbon atoms are present here. Okay, so to these carbon atoms you have to give that the numbers here. Now here that the our parent compound is again here that the benzene and the OH here, so you have to give the first priority that the which carbon atom, the carbon atom which contains that the OH group here. Okay, so this should be the first carbon atom and this should be the second carbon atom. Means on the second position here that the CH3 methyl group is present here, and our parent compound is here that the benzene is here. So therefore here it's a IUPAC is very simple one, and it is the 2-methylphenol. All of you understood here? Now, actually, why it is a 2-methylphenol? Because the as we give numbers here to the benzene ring here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, like that here. Okay, on the first position here, that OH group is present. If we are suppose here, then the CH3 group is on the second position, and therefore, on the second position, the methyl group is present. Therefore, it should be the 2-methyl, and our parent compound is the phenol. So, it's a IUPAC name is the 2-methylphenol. Then come toward that the next one structure. Now in this structure this should be the first position, this should be the second, this should be the third position. Means in this structure that on the third position here that methyl group is present here. Okay, therefore it is known as the 3-methylphenol. Okay, then the next structure is like this here. On the first position here, the OH group is present, this should be the second, this should be the third, and this should be the fourth position here. Means on the fourth position here that the methyl group is present here. Okay, so therefore it's IUPAC giving the 4-methylphenol here. Okay, now after this structure that come toward that the IUPAC name of the ortho nitrophenol here. Okay, so here again in this picture that OH group is present on the first carbon atom and the NO2 nitro group is present at the second position here. Okay, though here that the NO2 group as a functional group here, okay, and it is present on the second position here. So it's a IUPAC name the 2-nitrophenol. Okay, then definitely that in the next structure that the NO2 group is present at the third position. Therefore, it's IUPAC with the 3 nitrophenol. Then, in the next structure that the NO2 group is present at the fourth position. Okay, therefore, it's IUPAC with the 4 nitrophenol. And in the last structure that the BR is present at the second position. Therefore, the IUPAC name of the orthobromophenol is the 2-bromophenol. Okay, so in this way, we have seen the common names as well as IUPAC names of the monoidic phenols. Okay, now come toward that the second type of the phenol and is the dihydric phenol. Dihydric phenols. Now here the examples are like this here: benzylidene. On the benzylidene here that 2 OH groups are present. Okay, as these are the dihydric, means it contains like the 2 OH groups on the benzylidene here. This should be the one structure. Now this should be the second structure and one more structure. I will write here, and this is the OH and this is the OH. Now, as already I have stated here that the phenols are famous from their other names. Okay, like that, this is the orthoprison, metoprison, paraprison, like that. These are the here, first one, it is a catechol. This aromatic phenol compound is famous from the catechol. Then, next it is the resorcinol. And this compound is famous from the hydroxyquinone. Okay, now after these names, actually in their names that we can use here that ortho, meta and the para prefix. Okay, now first of all I will write here that their common names, and then again I will tell you that why these names came here. Okay, so this should be the here ortho dihydroxy benzene. Then next should be the here meta dihydroxy benzene. Meta dihydroxy benzene. And it should be the para dihydroxy benzene. Okay. Now see here that why these names came here. Now as already we have seen in the first, that is the type that when the two substituents are present in the adjacent position, then the ortho prefix is used. Okay. Therefore the prefix is the ortho. Okay. Now here as the 2 OH groups are present on the benzene ring, therefore the word is the dihydroxy. You know that that is 2, and which 2 groups are present here on the benzene? Hydroxy, which hydroxy groups are present on the benzene? Therefore, it is the ortho dihydroxy benzene. Okay, so it's a common name. Now, there is no need to take here that this should be the meta dihydroxy benzene, because the 2 OH groups are present in the alternate position here. Okay, and whereas in the last structure that 2 OH groups are present in the which position here? In the opposite position here, means like this here. Okay, therefore the prefix is the para prefix here, and therefore the common name of this structure is the ortho dihydroxy benzene. Understood? Now come toward that, the it's a IUPAC name. Okay.
Now, here the first structure's IUPAC name is the benzene 1,2 diol. Okay, now why it is a benzene 1,2 diol here? Because here on the benzene ring here that the two OH groups are present here on the benzene ring. Therefore, here the benzene word I have written here. And on which position here? On the first and the second position here. That's why I have mentioned here that the position 1,2 and the two OH groups are present here for the prefix is that the di and in the alcohols or the phenols that OL as a suffix, therefore the OL word is used here. Okay, therefore the IUPAC name of the catechol is the benzene 1,2 diol. It's a nomenclature, is a very simple one. Okay, now then the next that is the resource norm, it's a IUPAC name that is here on the first, second and on the third position here that the OH groups are present here. Therefore, its IUPAC name is the benzene 1,3 diol. And in the last structure that the here the OH group are present on the first and the fourth position here. Therefore, its IUPAC name is the benzene 1,4 diol. Okay, so in this way, this is the nomenclature of the dihydrogen phenols. Okay, whereas the last one, the type of the mono of the phenol is the trihydrate phenol. Trihydrate phenol. Now again, I will write here that some structures, and then we will discuss here that their names. Now OH here, OH and OH here. OH, OH and here OH and one more structure. So these are the structures here. Okay. Now, here, these structures are known from their another names, and that names are the first one that is the pyrogalon. Pyrogalon. This should be the fluorobutanol. Fluorobutanol. And it should be the hydroxy. Phenol, hydroxy, phenol. Now, as these three structures contain that the three OH groups on the benzene, all these three structures. Okay, therefore, all they are the examples of the trihydrate phenols. Okay, now, then come toward that our nomenclature or in nomenclature that the first one that is the common name systems. Actually, as already I have stated that actually from these names here that the these structures are famous. But here that the here according to this ortho, beta and para, which are their names. Now that we will see here that. Now here one point that I have told you here in the prefixes. What I have told you here when the benzene ring contains that the minimum two or maximum two substituents are present. In and in that case, that the ortho, beta, and the para prefix is used. Okay. Then here these structures are the three substituents on the benzene ring. Okay. Therefore, all these in their common, all these structures, their common names that there should be no ortho, meta and the para prefix. Okay, understood? So, once again, I would like to repeat this point here because all these structures contains that the three that the substituents, therefore, in their common names, there should be no ortho, no meta or no para. Okay?
So these structures have the IUPAC names here. Okay, and which are their IUPAC names? Actually, from these that the diatomic phenols, their IUPAC names are very simple. Now in diatomic phenols, the structure contains two OH groups here, whereas the in triadic phenols, that the structure contains that the three OH groups. Okay, so like this in that their IUPAC names are. Now first structures, its IUPAC name is benzene here, 1, 2 and 3. Benzene 1, 2, 3, triol. Okay, whereas this structure contains on the first, second, third, fourth and fifth position here that the OH groups are present. So here at which position here? Benzene 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 5, triol is the IUPAC. Whereas the last contains that on the first, second and on the fourth position here, the OH groups are present. Therefore, it's a IUPAC name is the benzene 1, 2, 4, triol. Okay. Now see here that we first in why these names came here, right? Because the structure, in the structure that there should be a benzene, that's why I have written that the first word, that is the benzene, and on the first, second and third position here that the OH groups are present. As the three OH groups are present, therefore the prefix is the tri here, and for the OH group here that the suffix is that the OH. Therefore its IUPAC name is benzene 1,2,3 tri. Okay, then in the next picture that on the benzene ring here, right, on the benzene ring here at the 1, 3 and the 5 position, the OH groups are present. Therefore its IUPAC name is benzene 1,3,5 tri. Okay, understood? And in the last picture that on the here first, second and on the fourth position here that the OH groups are present. Therefore it's a IUPAC in the benzene 1,2,4 tri. Okay, so in this way we have discussed the nomenclature of the phenols, and in their nomenclature that very important point about that the common name system is that in their common names ortho, meta and the para prefix is used. Okay, and in the IUPAC like that the aliphatic compounds, you have to give the numbers to the carbon atom that are present in the benzene. Okay, so in this way we have completed the nomenclature of the phenols. Okay, thank you.